first two segments of this join-up series, I showed you how to attain leadership through space and directing the movement of all 4 feet of your horse. I want here to show you the power of that space, how it changes the horse's mindset from refusal to willingness in a matter of only 5 minutes. Now, rarely do you see me carry a whip or a stick in order to help me, but in this horse, I had to make my space highly visible. I rarely touch a horse with the stick. I don't want to provoke a response to get a reaction. I want the horse to think, in other words, become interactive. The results, then, are softness and willingness. It also leads to lightness in the bridle and immediate response when under saddle. This is actually quite a wonderful horse, and is usually very compliant, but when it comes to backing up and backing out of my space, he refuses. You can see he's twisting his head to avoid pressure, tapping him with the whip on his shoulder, gets me a couple of little unwilling steps. Also, I want you to notice that resting back foot he placed very deliberately. A resting back foot does not always mean your horse is relaxed. In this case, it means you can't make me move my feet. So I'm going to work to get him back up on his foot. I'm going to direct his movement around a little bit. I want him on all 4 feet. That means that he's willing to move them for me. Here I go back to trying to move front shoulder. And you'll see it takes a lot of movement with the whip to get that done. I can, though, immediately just put the whip down and ask for him quietly to step over. So already I'm getting a little bit more willingness from him just because I made him move those front feet. I still didn't provoke a reaction. I just asked him to go. There I get a nice hind end yield just by pointing at his back end and looking. He still wants to come forward into my space, though, so I have to shove him back, and shove back hard. Now, I incorporate a foot stomp because that's how they talk to each other in the field. Look at the impact that had. Rather than tapping him with the stick, you see now he's licking and chewing, although it's sort of reluctant licking and chewing, and he's gone back to resting that back foot. So I'm going to bring him up to get him back up onto his feet again. And he's kind of sort of refusing here a little bit. So I just keep the pressure on until he decides to release the pressure for himself. There. Now he's up on his feet. So I'm going to ask him for another step. I'd like him to give to the pressure a little faster and not pull back into it. Now here's an important point. This horse is now doing what I'm asking him to do, but look at the expression on his face. I wouldn't say it was actually willing and engaged at this point, but I do now have his attention. He's turning to look at me and face me. So you notice I'm being very slow about my movements. I want him to think his way through, and the second he moves his feet as I'm asking him to do, I stand quietly in terms of reward. Just drop my head and shoulders, and that's his reward. And here's the real turning point. He goes for grass, I smack the ground, and look what happens. He steps, backs away, turns and looks at me, and puts his ears right on me. The conversion for this horse occurred when I did my foot stomp and made him step back away from me with just my space. Here, you see, all of a sudden, now I can just tell him, get out of my space, and he's quick to do so. This is the foundation for true respect and trust. Once you can move your horse with space and have him following my movements, looking toward me for information, then I know that I'm attaining leadership. Now he's very light, and he's following me. I just keep repeating foot movement. Now, at no time did I actually ever smack him with that whip. I used it only to clear the space and make it big in front of me. It's extremely important to remember to bring the pressure way down to the very subtle. This is where you get the most cooperation and willingness from your horse. Now it's just a small butterfly touch and a lean with my body to get him to move his front feet. As I turn my shoulders now, look at the expression on his face. He's very happy to watch what I'm asking for. And this is all you need, is just a footstep here or there. You don't have to have big movements from your horse. You don't have to drive him backwards forever. But you just need to be able to move his feet a little at a time. So what we have now is a soft, willing horse who's engaged with me. He's looking right at me, staying out of my space, moving with me. He's following my movements only. These are not trained maneuvers. This is just repeating for him, stay with me. So he can turn into quite the dancer as a result. And as soon as I turn my shoulders, then he joins up at my shoulder with me and is ready for a nice walk. This horse has the opposite problem. He's actually gets quite anxious, and it comes across as being pushy, actually, and sometimes seems resistant, but it's not what the case. All right, so in this case, so you see how he's throwing his hip away from, see that flinching?
Mm.
So you see, I dropped this way down. See, the flinch is right where I'm looking at. Expression here is stressed. Not being very efficient, so I'm going to take him around this circle in shuffling.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Now he did that correctly, so that's when I stopped. It wasn't beautiful, but it was better.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where he actually crossed over, stepped inside, placed his feet. So then you stop and let him think on that for a minute. His avid licking and chewing tells me that he's beginning to understand the exercise, and he's relaxing. We must give our horses time to process the information. This horse is definitely giving me try, and actually is moving away from me way too fast and in a very unbalanced fashion. Under a lot of pressure, he gets stressed. So it doesn't look like I'm putting a lot of pressure on, but I have to keep dropping the pressure and dropping the pressure to keep him from scurrying. Now, under saddle, he had a reputation for occasionally bucking and running sideways. You often see that in a horse who's anxious under high pressure situations. So it's my job to bring his anxiety levels down so he understands what he's doing. It's very important that this horse become mentally engaged and understand exactly what all of his our expectations of him are. He has a habit of trying maybe a little too hard. So then he ends up being unbalanced and just shuffling his body around in an attempt to do what he's being asked for. Under saddle, what happens in that situation is they're trapped in the bridle, people are pushing them to go forward, and if they don't understand what they're doing, that confusion leads to bad under saddle behavior. I'm pretty sure that this is exactly what this horse's problem is, and we'll see when we get to the saddle work. But on evaluation from the ground, you see he's not smooth. He just kind of throws his body around. So this is what I'm working on right now. He's willing, but he doesn't really understand how to move himself around well. I'm continuing to keep moving him the same way. This is not about getting hind end yields for disengagement. Actually, I'm attempting to engage his back end instead of having him throw it around, like here, you see he gets a little bit stuck, and then he just throws his hip. I want him to smoothly place his feet. And in order to do so, he has to push his balance to the back, squat down just a little tiny bit in order to engage his hindquarters. So I just keep continuing to show him. You see him looking at me. He's really giving it thought. And that's the major event that I want to come out of this session. You see him looking and thinking on it. So I don't bring up the pressure. I want him to think on it. Now you'll notice that he's starting to come under himself for those hind end yields, shifting his balance backwards, and then he's smoother in placing his feet. I know it seems like a stretch that this exercise actually teaches your horse to calmly engage his back end, but this is about working together as a team. It's more comfortable for him if he just releases his neck at the withers, shifts his balance to the back, and places his feet. This can be a learned response. Often we aren't very patient about these things, and we also look at it as, well, if this is a hind end yield, he's doing that. He's just not doing it well. This horse's constant tail swishing when told what to do that he doesn't truly understand tells me that he will take exception if pushed too hard. So that's another reason I take my time and put these pauses in. It gives him time to think about it, and then you see him avidly start licking and chewing. That licking and chewing is a reflection that he understands what he's supposed to do. It is not strictly an act of submission. And I'm not interested in having them submit to me. I'm interested in them participating with me. There's a very big difference there. So now we have a calm, balanced, quiet, willing, soft, engaged horse who understands the exercise, is actually not just shuffling his body around, he's deliberately placing his feet, crossing over his hindquarters. He totally understands the exercise. Look at how he's smiling. The culmination then is we can actually do the twist. Now, maybe the twist isn't that practical, but what does it take for the horse to do the twist? He has to step under himself. He has to have some impulsion at a standstill. Primarily, he has to have willingness. And this will all transfer to under saddle work.